Welcome students, myself Satyabrata Sharma. I am assistant professor on the Faculty of Pharmaceutical Science, Assam Dongpan University, Department of Pharmacy. So I am discussing about the large molecule and small molecule parenterals. Now, today I am going to discuss about the additive use in the large molecule and small molecule parenterals. So let's start with the all discussions. So students, today I am going to discuss about the additives of small and large molecule parenteral equations. So first of all, I am going to start on this. So what is the, I am discussing about the formulation aspects of the that is large molecule small molecule parenterals. That is, for therapeutic agents, that is example insulin antibiotics, vaccines, antibiotics, analgesics, and dextrose, sodium chloride solution, and electrolytes. That is, vehicle is water, and aqueous vehicle is ethyl alcohol, propylene glycol. Non-aqueous vehicle is fixed oils, that is, like corn oil, peanut oil, cotton seed oil, etc. So let's discuss about the additive substance which we are using in the large and small molecule parenterals. First one is the antimicrobials. The examples are phenyl microbial acid, that is, we are using 0.1%. Okay, so thiomersal, that is 0.01%. Then benzethylium chloride, that is 0.01%. Phenol and sterol, that is 0.5%. So these are the examples of some antimicrobials. Now antioxidants we are using, that is sodium bisulfite, ascorbic acid, thioiridia. Okay, so these are the examples of some antioxidants using the SLVA, small volume and large volume parenterals. Next, buffering agent is citric acid and sodium citrate. Bulking agent is lactose and mannitol. So these are the some examples of some antioxidants, buffering agent, bulking agent, and antimicrobials. So next example is silating agents. So what is the silating agents we are using? That is diisodium aditate, that is 0.003% to 0.05%, and tetrasodium aditate, that is 0.01%. We are using in the small volume and large volume parenterals. So protectants, we are using sucrose and lactose, that is 2 to 5%, and solubilizing agent, that is quinine and polysorbates, and toxicity and adjusting agents is sodium sulfate and sorbitol, and surfactants we are using polyethylene, that is 0.1% to 0.5%, sorbitol, and monolate, that is 0.05% to 0.25%. So these are mainly excipients we are using for the preparation of small volume and large volume parenterals. So next come with the vehicles. What are the vehicles we are using? So first vehicle is the water for injection, that is water that is intended for the use in the manufacture of parenteral products, that is injectable drugs, whose solvent is water. Okay, the USP unit, state pharmacopoeia, define this as a highly purified waters containing less than 10 CFU per 100 ml of aerobic bacteria, is used in the preparation of small volume and large volume parenterals. Next is the sterilized water for injection. So sterile non-pyrogenic and distilled water is a single dose container for intravenous administration after addition of suitable solution. So it may also be used as a dispensing container for diluent use. The pH is 5.5, okay, that means in between 5 to 7. The antimicrobial or other substances has been added. So these are the mainly additives we are using in the preparation of small volume and large volume parenterals. Next come with the containers. What are the containers we are using for the, that means packaging materials? That's it. So first is the glass. So glass is the mainly four type of glass, that is type 1, type 2, type 3, and type 4. So type 1 glass is highly resistant, that is borosilicate glass. Next is the type 2 glass, that is treated soda lime glass, and type 3 glass, that is regular soda lime glass, and another type 4 is non, that is parenteral glass. Okay, so type 4 glass, it is not used for the packaging of small volume and large volume parenterals. Next is the plastic. So plastic containers are used, but they face following problems. Okay, some problems are there in case of plastic materials, that is permeation, and another one is absorption and leaching, then softening. So these are the main problems for our plastic items. Next come the rubbers. So to provide closure for multiple dose vials, IV fluid bottles, plugs for the dispersible syringes, and valves for the ophthalmic pipettes, rubber is the material for choice. Okay. So some problems are there in case of rubber as a closures. So these problems are incompatibility, chemical instability, and physical instability. So these are the main materials we are using for the packaging as a packaging or sealing material for the small volume and large volume products. So this is this class for the all about the additives and packaging materials of the small volume and large volume products. So hope students, all of you are understood on the classes. So from the next class we are starting about the other part of the large volume and small volume products.